Disclaimer. In this episode, there are two separate runs. In the first run, Guy ends up getting killed by the boss. He's a pretty important unit, so I do the chapter again. I'm keeping both runs because I feel like I explained a lot of things pretty well in the first part. Also, I feel like I would be doing a disservice by not showing everything about this run. I apologize if you feel like this is save scumming, but I think this is one of the ways Fire Emblem is a great game because it allows us to learn from our mistakes and try to make better decisions in future playthroughs. I will be placing timestamps at the end of this wall of text, so if you want to see everything, then continue watching. If not, then you can skip to the winning run. Thank you for watching. Hello everybody and welcome to Autovox Plays Fire Emblem. In the last chapter, we got done with chapter 16x, now it's time to begin chapter 17. Vargas's ship sails along smoothly. At last, they spot a fog-enshrouded isle on the horizon. Elowit's father is on the isle, as is the Dragon's Gate. As they draw closer to the isle, Elowit no longer fears that his father might be one of the conspirators. As the moment of truth nears, Elowit only prays that he is safe. Chapter 17, Pirate Ship.
Ahoy, laddie! You don't get seasick, do you?
I'm fine, sir. This is a beautiful ship.
Gwa-ha-ha! For a sea rover, eh?
May I ask you a question?
What is it?
Why did you agree to give us passage? When we said that we wished to travel to Valor, the people in the harbor treated us as though we were mad. I'm sure they did. It is the Dread Isle, after all. If not for good reason, we wouldn't want to go either. And yet, you've given us free passage. Why is that?
Listen to me, laddie. Men are strange beasts. We can't resist a challenge.
Something appears on the horizon, and we immediately set sail. Some dreams we conquer, others we abandon. I've grown old. I haven't had a good challenge in many a year. Then you moonclaves appear, seeking passage to the Dread Isle. I was impressed with your courage. I think you might be the ones to survive the Dread Isle. We won't disappoint you. We will return. Alright, then we'll weigh anchor and wait for you. Light a signal fire when you want to return and we'll pick you up. Thank you.
Captain, there's a dory adrift to port. It looks like there's someone aboard. What are your orders?
Bring him aboard.
Looks like we've got a visitor.
Odd though, finding a boat adrift near here.
Odd, why is that?
The sea currents in this area. Anything drifting around here must have come for the Dread Isle.
Oh.
Shall we greet our guest?
Elowit, you done talking to old man Fargas? You saw us?
No, I heard you'd gone off with him. You learn anything?
We can trust him. We got lucky finding him.
If you say so.
Hey, you two, come here. They pulled a dory aboard. I wonder who's aboard. It's a girl.
Ahoy, you there.
Me?
Give me a hand, will you? I don't know where to... Grab her.
Okay. Such the gentleman.
Stow it.
Ninian?
Ninian, wake up.
Unbelievable. What are the chances? Do you know her?
She's how Lindis and I met a year back.
I rescued Ninian from a band of villains.
Please, Ninian, open your eyes.
Ninian, can you hear me? Are you well? Why were you on that boat? Where's Nils? Why wasn't he with you?
Ninian?
Lindis, something's wrong with her.
Who?
Captain! Pirate ship's approaching from the northwest. Do they dare attack Captain Fargas and the Davros?
They must be mad.
What flag are they flying? I've never seen that pattern before.
These seas belong to us. Whoever they are, they're in our waters.
This is a day of strange occurrences, it seems.
You whelps watch your own hides. We've no time to waste on you.
Water! There's been... The hall's been breached. We're taking on water.
Breach? Those scums were more dangerous than I thought.
It's bad, Captain. We'll need all hands below deck or we'll sink.
Take care of it. I'm going to carve these scallywags some new gizzards.
We need your help. The water's up to the galley. You must come below, Captain.
Vargas, leave the enemy to us. Fighting is something we're good at. But a sinking ship? That's your affair. You have to do something or we'll all drown. We'll deal with things up here. Please, hurry.
Fine, the deck is yours.
I'll be back as soon as we plug the breach in the hull.
Go!
Lynn, take her to that room.
I will.
Here they come.
All we want is the girl. Kill the rest.
Alright, let's take a look at the map. So we got a bunch of magic users to the left of us. Okay, that's pretty standard. Bunch of shamans, surprisingly. This might actually be an opportunity for Lucius to get some free XP. And another thing is that there's a bunch of mercenaries to the right. Now, you might be thinking, hey, we should send our magic users to the right, and we should send our lance reavers like Florina. To the right. It's not necessarily the best idea. Okay, I'll explain as soon as I can find it. Some of these units actually have lance reavers. From what I remember. Yep, there's one unit has a lance reaver. There's a couple archers. And I imagine all these guys are flux users. It would make the most sense. Yeah, Nosferatu. And, one of the things that we actually should really do is we want to take Matthew along with us. Matthew, because of the fact that Zuldum actually has a speed wing. Speed wings are another one of those things that we can use to increase a person's stats. It increases speed by 2, and this is actually very important. Well, it's not critical, but it's something we would like to have. So that's what we're going to actually try to do. Anyway, so we're going to bring Matthew along, and we'll rescue him. Zuldum is actually pretty fucking scary. He's a level 18 shaman with 28 health. He actually has a good amount of defense and resistance. So any sort of magic attack we were to take against him, he would just straight up tank that shit, no problem. A guiding ring, this is actually very important too. It's a promotion item for magic wielders and troubadours. So as soon as we can get any magic users such as Urk, Lucius, Canis, and Priscilla, as soon as we can get them to level 20, that's when we'll be using our promotion items. And the same goes for anyone who uses a hero crest or a knight crest. So getting that guiding ring is pretty damn important. Luckily it's one of those green items that we actually will pick up as soon as we kill this dude, so not too big of a deal. But we do want to kill this because I think this is one of those this is one of those things where we have to, like, survive for a certain amount of time. Alright, considering this, let's clear everyone out. I just want to start fresh. So, we definitely know we want to take Priscilla. That much is certain. And I do want to take Canis. I do want to take Lucius. Florina will definitely be helpful just because of the fact that she can fly over onto the sea and she's not restricted solely to just staying onto the boat. So that's pretty damn helpful. Let's go back in and we'll see who else we actually have. Matthew's definitely coming along because of the fact that we need him to steal that speed wing. I want to take Raven along as well just because I want him to get as much experience as possible. Alrighty, so who else do we have left? We have a total of 4 more slots left. Let's see. We definitely don't want to bring Lynn along because she's very overleveled for this point. All the units down here aren't necessarily ones that we would particularly want to take. Let's take Rebecca. We can take Urk, we can take Guy. And sorry, I'm just clearing this out really quickly so we know who else we can take. If anything, I can also take Oswin, mostly for the fact that he is pretty freaking tanky. And he can actually go on to the left. Hector and Lynn are again, very strong, so they won't be coming along with us. Bart isn't going to be of much use either, even though he's one of the units that we're actually going to be using a lot of. So let's take Oswin, because I can't really think of anyone else that I would particularly want to take. Oh, let's take Dorcas, let's take Lowen. Oh, let's take Marcus. No, we don't want any of these fools. So I think this is fine. Let's go up here and transfer this Devil Axe. Give that. Cool. All right. So Canis, you will transfer, give that back. And we will transfer these to here. This looks fine to me, although let's sell this. And I'll let her use the steel bow, because she's fast enough so that she can actually get a couple hits on with that. And she might actually get 3 attacks of 2 attacks on an enemy, if that makes sense. Anyway. This is fine. This is fine. And that's fine. We want to make it so that we can purchase more of the tomes for these homies, so that's something we gotta do. Let's give Lucius another lightning tome, even though it's the only thing he can use right now, so might as well give him an extra copy. Do we have any dark magic? We do not, so we definitely want to make it so that we can give Canis another one of those. Let's give one of these staves back, and we'll take one of the mending staves. It looks good to me. Alright. Let's take a look at the map, and we'll figure out who we want to go where. Oh, first things first. Let's get an augury.
Yes. So you seek insight to your next battle, 50 gold. Stay still. Choose your ground and fight where you stand. Danger for knights, armor slayers to the east, magic to the west. You'd understand when the fighting starts. Pegasus knights, yes. It couldn't hurt to have thieves along, either.
Alright, basically. So, from what she did say, there are armor slayers. I imagine someone's gonna come up with an armor slayer. Don't know who, but someone will. Okay, yes. These are the weapons that they have for sale, which is pretty damn nice. We probably should pick up some of the steel axes. Some steel bows. Maybe some... just a couple steel things in general. So that's good. And on here... yeah, we will definitely pick up a couple flux tomes. Other than that, I don't think we need anything else, because we have a good amount of fire tomes, good amount of thunder, and we just bought a couple lightning ones, so this is totally fine. Alright, considering that. Formation. Matthew, you're going to the right. And Lucius, you're gonna go here. We'll put the ranged units in the back. That looks fine. You are gonna go here. And you're here. Okay, this looks alright. If anything, Canis, go down here. Matthew, over there. I think I can make do with this. So we're gonna have Raven, Oswin going to the right. We're gonna have the magic users going over here. They have a couple ranged units, like we have a good mix of melee and also ranged attacks on either side. So we'll figure it out from there. Anyway, let's save the formation, because it's been about like 14 minutes since this recording even started. Holy shit, prep takes so goddamn long. Alright, let's begin! Merlinus is level 9! Yes, we will deploy Merlinus. Ugh, I'm gonna be sick. Doesn't this bother you, Autobox? The ship moves too much. I can still fight, though. My sword arm's fine. Ahoy! We'll leave the fighting to you. Hold on until we can help. Oh, we've merchants aboard. This is the armory. And this is the shop. You won't be able to stock up once you reach the Dread Isle. I suggest you buy as much as possible while you have the chance. Alright, so we have to survive for a total of 11 turns. So let's get it underway. So, okay, we don't get any bonus from the stairs, so that's pretty normal, I guess. If anything, Lucius can flat out kill these guys, but we can also send Canis up here as well. So I'll place him here. That's good. And I'll place him over here. This is gonna get a little dicey. If anything, I don't think I want to attack just yet. I'll have him wait here. It's because I want to funnel the units to attack this way. Send a unit over here. Send you over here. Because the thing is that we can place it. We can make it so that he can still get attacked. That's kind of a problem. So if anything, these units will actually, the shaman will most likely want to go over here and attack the unit like Raven, who can't actually do anything against him. So if we place our ranged units over here, I'm thinking that if they do end up attacking him, we will have the option of like retaliating, I guess. Because this guy will definitely attack Raven. He doesn't have a choice with that. And we can probably make it so that some of these other units will be able to, like, take care of him. Anyway, let's see. You will go over here. And you should be able to handle some of these guys. Guy, you're gonna go here. Matthew, you're gonna go down here. And we're gonna place we're gonna place Canis close up to here, because he's a little tankier than Lucius, so that should be totally fine for us to handle that. Because I imagine that placing, oh hey, he got the crit. Alright, sick. Yeah, because I imagine placing a magic user kind of right here might also attract this mercenary to come over and attack him. Anyway, so you're gonna go here, when we will wait. Elwood, you're probably gonna stay in the back, if anything. We can have you purchase some of the stuff, so that shouldn't be too much of a problem, and we can also have Priscilla go out and buy some things as well, because no one needs healing right now. So you will buy a steel sword. You'll buy a steel bow. Anything else we could possibly need? Alright, we'll wait for now. But I do want to make it so that we definitely have some more tomes. Let's vendor. And buy. Alright, good. And you can wait here. Alright, let's see how this turn plays out. Okay. Priscilla will definitely be healing Raven. Alright, yeah, I expected as much. Alright, cool. Candace actually got to level 9. Hopefully something good. Good rolls. Fuck. He only got speed. Alright, good. They're not going to be able to do any damage to him. Oswin is not going to be fast enough to actually attack these guys. So if anything, we can make it so that the other units, like Rebecca, Urk, someone who can attack over him can get some nice XP. And hell, if we can probably use Florina to actually do a good amount of the damage for us. Alright, cool. You're definitely going to get healed by Priscilla. I'm confident in Canis to actually be able to, like, just straight up kill the rest of these shamans. He's pretty damn strong. And if Lucius managed to get some extra XP, that is not a problem. Alright, Canis will definitely get the kill on this guy, which is pretty fucking sweet. Good shit. Now. Alrighty. So, you are going to attack this guy and clean him up. Bam. Good stuff. And you got a level. Alright, some skill and some HP. I think that's okay. That'll do for now. Okay, so now let's see, who exactly do we want to get some XP? Anything? We'll see how this can go. We can have Raven go over here, and Rebecca can definitely get the kill onto this guy, and we could probably make it so that Raven can get a kill, like a shot, to kill him as well. That might be helpful. Interesting. Now, here's what I'm thinking, is that we could Osmond doesn't necessarily need to be up here. If anything, he is slow enough so that we can actually, like, get people low. He's slow enough to get one attack in, and he's also tanky enough to actually not take too much damage. We can make it so that so we can switch Osmond back and forth, and maybe he can, like, lower the enemy's health enough so that way our weaker units, kind of like Raven, can come up and get the kill. I don't know how viable that is, though, because there's no convenient way to switch these units out. Because if anything, I would need to have one of these units, either him or him killed, and then we can actually swap them out, kind of like that. But I do want to kill the Shaman, and I do want Raven to get a kill somehow. Because... Okay, so here's what I might do. Irk, you need some XP, so go down here and see if you can kill this guy. You have a 15... You have 81% chance to get the kill onto him, and I hope you do. Thank you! Good stuff, good stuff. Now, since this unit is dead, we can actually place Oswin down here. Oswin, go down here. And we'll see how you can fare against these guys. You should be able to get the kill on the Shaman, so that nullifies any of the extra nonsense that we would have otherwise would have had to deal with him here. So let's place him here. Good. So we got the kill off. Now we can actually heal Raven, and then we can place him up here where he can easily get the kill. So that's pretty good. So we'll use the men staff so that you can. Like, heal. You're gonna get. Guaranteed, you're gonna get it back to the full health, and it's more XP for Priscilla. So, good things all together. Let's see. Yeah, you're definitely gonna get the kill on him. Is there any way we can actually make it so that you would get a guaranteed kill, though? No, it doesn't look like it. Alright, anyway, go in there and riggedy wreck their collective shit. Alright, good. So, if anything, Florina does need some XP, but it's not super important for her to actually do that. So, if anything, we can place her here, and... Let me place her right here. And... Okay, now let's handle the right side. Well, the left side. So, Canis is... taking a little bit of damage. If he were to get attacked by either one of these two, he won't exactly die, and he does make a prime target for him to get healed. Let's see. Rebecca is not going to be able to get anywhere near, but that's fine. We can place her here. Neither will Guy. Okay, that's fine. If we were to have Matthew going here, he definitely would be able to get a kill off on some of these people, but it's not strictly necessary for him to go in and get the attack, just because of the fact that he might actually end up getting attacked by one of these shaman. Yeah, he would attract the attention of one of the shaman there, but is that necessarily a bad thing? Okay, hear me out. It's good because Matthew would most likely get to a level 11, but it'd be drawing XP from either Lucius or Canis. Okay, if anything, let's hold off. Let's hold off. I want to make it so that Lucius and Gannis will get some XP, and if he gets... A higher level units will be used to pick up the scraps, so this is fine. Alright, good. And Matthew, you'll wait here. Ellawood, you're gonna go here and wait. Alright, let's see how this plays out. He'll be taking 5 damage, but he should be able to finish him off. Wait, whoa, what the fuck? Thought he was fast enough to get 2 attacks in. Alright. Good. We might have to do that awkward swap thing back and forth. Just so that Raven can get a guaranteed kill. Cool beans. Good job, Canis. Okay. But I would have liked if you got some of that extra damage from other people. Alright, there's the Armor Slayers. If anything, he's only level 4. Nah, you wouldn't have done shit to Oswin. Alright. So who is in need of healing? Raven's definitely in need of healing. Alright, so let's see. You're good enough to actually get an attack off. You know what? This is good. Florina, you are going to apply some damage onto these homies. And, Erk, go in here and get the kill. Yeah, get the kill this way. Because you are slightly falling behind. And Lucius, go here and sweep the floor up with these people. I'm gonna draw Canis back a little bit and have him wait. But we'll put Lucius forward, so that way he can get some guaranteed XP. Because with him out there, it should bait the other shamans to attack Lucius instead of Canis. And if anything, Lucius is our least leveled magic user, so this will be totally fine. Alright, good. Now, let's see. Priscilla, go over here and heal Canis up. Use your men's staff. Alright, cool. Now, this places our units a little bit forward. I'm gonna keep our units the way they are right now. But let's have Florina go over here and do a bit of damage onto him. Yeah, that should be totally fine. Just getting one hit off. We want to make it so that she doesn't actually get a crit, because that would draw XP from Raven. Alright, so get a attack in. Bam. Alright, sick. Level 7. You know what? That's actually amazing. Good job. A good level up. I'll leave Oswin here. He doesn't need to move forward. He really doesn't. And if they were even move the archer here, they still wouldn't be able to attack Florina. This is fine. Yeah, he wouldn't be able to attack Florina. So if anything, this is good. This is totally okay. I'll position our other units forward once this shaman is dead. And yeah, everything should be more or less in order. So let's end right now. From what I remember, there are other units that will spawn in this map, so we don't need to worry too much about that. Just because we can have Florina and maybe the other magic users, and we definitely have an archer, so the winged units won't be that much of a problem. Oh, sweet. He's faster than the mercenaries now, so they can actually get a double attack in. Oh, Black Fang Shaman, you're gonna get your collective shit wrecked by Lucius. Alright, good. Hey, we got a guiding ring. Is it the same unit that had the guiding ring? Yeah, he moved up here. Okay, I was like, oh, we might get two guiding rings. Oh, that would have been sick. I mean, that would have been sick, but... Nah. Alrighty. So you're almost level 10, which is good. And you're healed up enough so that I don't feel too bad about placing you up here. It'll draw aggro from the other people, but that'll be fine. Canis, you're gonna follow along as well. Matthew, you're coming here. And so is Guy. Alright. So this guy is gonna be fine. This'll make it so that Urk can go ahead and get the kill on him. He'll also pick up the longsword, which is pretty nice, I suppose. Alright, good. Finally, you actually have some decent growth. You've only been getting, like, a bunch of points in HP. So that's actually fantastic. So we're gonna have him get an attack in. Yeah, this will be good. And then we'll have Priscilla heal Raven up. Alright, so go over here. Heal your brother up. Alright, sick. You are almost level 10, I think? Yeah, almost level 10. If anything, you can come along. Actually, wait, we probably should keep Rebecca and Elowit up here. Mostly because there are ranged units who are gonna come and they might attack. So here, Lorena, you're fine, and we'll keep everyone where they are. Yeah, this is good. This is totally fine. Right, end. Oh, you poor misguided soul. You tried. Yeah, you should get the double attack off just because armor slayers are pretty damn heavy. Good. Now, let's see. Yeah, Lucius is gonna kill this guy, no problem, no problem. Yeah, Nosferatu is a little- oh, hey, the crit! Nosferatu is one of those, it's a tome where it draws the HP of any that- it returned- it's like Life Leech? Yeah, it heals you for the amount of damage that you did to the opponent. Alright, cool. So, these are definitely people who we are going to attack. Yeah, this is good. This is totally fine. So, I'm gonna place Oswin down here, and Raven should be totally strong enough to actually take these guys out. Yeah, he'll be strong enough to get the double attack in, so go ahead and do that. Yeah, Raven is gonna be a major, major unit for us, so we wanna get him as strong as possible, as quickly as possible. It would've been better if you actually got his strength and... like, you know, skill, like, speed bonus? Yeah, whatever, this is fine. Yeah, let's just return the Iron Blade. It's a little heavy. So now, let's see, who can we possibly heal? Urk, you are fine, you're level, like, fucking 12 right now, so we'll have you get healed. Priscilla, now... okay. Now, Florina, you actually are gonna go along to the right as well. I mean, to the left as well. And you two are gonna be placed here. And placed right here. Cool. Okay, the right is taken care of. Now, Canis and Lucius, take these two guys out. So one of the reasons why we want to place Florina onto the left side of the map is so that, one, she can rescue Matthew, and two, she should have the ability to actually withstand a lot of the attacks that the Dark User, like the boss of this map, will actually be doing to us, because The random crit he can get off will fuck us up really, really badly, because it's a pretty heavy hitting spell, that's for sure. I think it's Luna is the tome he's using. It's a dark spell. Yeah, Luna. And oh fuck, it negates enemy resistance. That's a little scary. That is actually a little scary. Okay, and it's probably based off of the amount of magic he does. He does a total of 12. So 12, and he gets a crit, that's times 3. That's like 36 damage that he could just do onto one person. And that's pretty fucking scary. So if anything, we'll place you here, and we'll place him here. Alright, cool. So you're probably asking, why the hell are is Guy coming along to the left? The reason we're putting Guy to the left is because he has a killing edge. It could have been anybody, but he has the killing edge. Alright, dodge around. Damn it. You two are gonna stay there, and we will heal you up. Yay, level 10! Woo! So one of the cheekier things we can actually do is we can promote to the Troubadour right now. But that's not ideal because that's a total of 10 levels that would be missing out on skill points. Or not skill points, on stat boost. Like, stat boost? Yeah, I guess. So let's not worry too much about that. You are gonna go here. And we'll leave our units more or less the same, like in their positions. Everything looks totally fine to me. So here's the thing. Let me place Oswin here. He's not going to attack, but he'll stop the unit from actually attacking Florina. Not Florina, Priscilla, because he can't move forward. Yes, he's not going to be able to attack her. He can attack Raven. That's not a problem because he'll get healed up by Priscilla. And if anything, I'll place Matthew here. Okay, actually, wait. One, two. So if he is here. One, two, three, four, five. Oh yeah, he'll be in range to steal the speed wings, and he'll also be in range for Florina to actually pick him up. So that's fine. Canis and Lucius will stay here because I think there actually going to be some extra shamans spawning in that location. So let's end right now. Where the hell are the Pegasus Knights? I totally thought there were actually going to be reinforcements spawning. I mean, if not, that's fine. Get the kill on here, Raven. Good. What level are you going to be? Oh hey, you got a red gem. Send that back to Merlinus. And let's go here, merch. Give this back, and we will take. Where's the red gem? We might as well sell it. Cool. Now, who is in need of healing? Urk, if anything, can get healed. And we'll place him over here. Just so that way Priscilla can go over here and heal up anybody who would get hit by Luna. Alright, cool. Now, Matthew, go down here and steal the speed wings. Nice. Matthew, you will get rescued. And you are out of range. Cool. Move down here preemptively. I want to place all my units so that way they can all attack at once. And this is fine. Yeah, this is fine. We will wait. And there you go. Move around to the enemy's ship stern. This is where they should be waiting. That's where they'll die. Oh, hey, yeah. Okay, cool. Hey, what's up? That's where the reinforcements are coming from. Oops. Alright, well, you're gonna attack. You're gonna stay here. Oswin, stay here. And Florina, you're gonna drop Matthew off back over here. Actually, yeah, you're gonna drop Matthew off back right there. Drop him off. Actually, we'll drop you off here. Drop there. And we'll put you back here. Right, let's just take a see how...
Oh, that's scary. A 21 crit. That's not good.
Okay, fuck. That's still a 16% chance of crit. How much with the killing edge? You might be able to do it. I'll put my faith in Guy. Oh, that's fucking scary. Okay. Place you here, next to Matthew. You're gonna go here. Yeah, this is fine. This is totally good. I'll wait. Raven should totally be able to handle these guys, no problem. But still, that's actually pretty terrifying. Gosh. Just the 1/5 chance of me getting completely wrecked is very scary. Oh, hey. There's actually a unit here who spawned. He has an iron sword. Alright. Oh, shit. This is scary. Alright, so, Florina, how are you gonna do against him? You... that's still like a 12% chance. He's less likely to hit if you use your steel lance... If you use your slim lance? Okay, so here's my thinking. I'm heavily banking on this killing edge to get that 30% crit. Banking on that. But if he's not able to get that crit off in that one point, then we might be fucked. Okay, so if anything, we can use Florina to get an attack in. It's slightly scary too, just because of the fact that there is a Pegasus Knight around here. Granted, this person is still using a steel lance, and if we surround Guy, or whoever is going to attack with this, then they shouldn't be completely dead. And Guy is, if you were to take that regular hit, I think it's a total of 12 damage. Yeah, it's a total of about 12. Barring whether or not, if he gets critted, then he's dead. He's just straight up dead. There's nothing I can do about that. And that's bad. Because I'd really rather not have to do this over again. Okay. So, if anything, holy shit, Raven is hurting badly. So, let's have some of these units get cleaned up first. Matthew, go ahead and get a kill. Because I need Priscilla to get over there and heal him up. Okay, there are 3 units total. You're gonna get a kill regardless. And maybe Urk is close enough so that we can actually kill the shaman? Alright, cool. Oswin, kill this guy. Actually, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ugh, shit. You have a move speed of 4? 1, 2, 3, 4. You can attack with this. Alright, well, at least get the kill off on him. Oh, yo, the crit! Alright, coolio. She can definitely heal him up, which is good. We'll place him down here, and we will place Priscilla. Actually, hold up. This might sound silly, but okay, let's see how far. Staff. I don't think this will work. There's like a 3% chance of hitting. that was worth a try. Fuck. If only we had a better chance of actually doing it. That would have been amazing to actually put him to sleep. But whatever. Okay, so if we do have Florina attack here. Either way, this person is still gonna get attacked with that steel lance, and the steel lance is gonna be hitting pretty hard. Oh, Grant, god damn it, this is scary. Okay. Fuck it. Okay, we gotta do this. I'm like pussyfooting around so hard. Okay, so we place you here. And we can get this Slim Lance to go off. Okay, do it. Fuck it, do it. Don't worry about any ambush. Board their ship. You don't know how to fight. Go now, or die here. Please don't die here, please don't die here, please don't die here, please don't die here, please don't die here. Yes! Fuck you! No crit! And that still hurts. Oh, okay. Guy, I need you to get a guaranteed crit. You have a 30% chance to get to straight up murk this guy. Please! Alright, channel. Channel! Fuck. No! Fuck! 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 Shit. Fuck. It's an hour of recording gone. Fuck. Oh, that's so annoying. Fuck. All he had to do is get that 30% fucking chance. Damn it! God damn it. You piece of shit, guy. You piece of shit. You had a better crit chance too, you fucking asshole. Alright. Hello everybody and welcome to Autobox Plays Fire Emblem. I don't know if you saw the last one. If you can see, we have restart chapter. I'll have to figure out what I actually got to do with it, but if I haven't put it up, basically what ended up happening is that, Guy kicked the bucket, and I actually really want Guy, so we're gonna redo it the chapter again. I don't exactly know how we'll do, but let's get onto it. Anyway, yeah, let's fucking erase this shit. There you go, bam. Yeah, we'll skip all this extra nonsense, because I more or less set everything up. Alright, let's take a look at the map, see everything is as I put it. Yes, everything is as I put it, so let's just get started. Yes, let's deploy Merlinus, thank you. Alright, we're more or less going to be doing it the same way as we did before, holy shit. Who needs the XP? Canis needs the XP, so Canis will go right here. But yeah, basically what ended up happening is that the part of the strategy that I needed to do, that I needed to get right on the last episode, it completely, like, failed, it flopped on my face. It's because RNGesus was not with me, but it was with the opponent, and I got my literal shit kicked in, so that wasn't very fun. Anyway, apart from that, like, everything's going more or less completely fine. I just gotta make sure that I do more of the same shit that I was doing in the last one. So, yeah, you're gonna get the... How exactly do I want to do this? Because if I'm trying to take any lessons from the other happening. I'll put these guys down here. So, yeah, if I'm trying to gain any lessons from what actually ended up happening, we can definitely keep Florian over here, because that was really, really helpful. But I need to make it so that he can get some attacks off. And the only way to do that is against, maybe, well, Oswin? Okay, fine. He can only really go here, so let's put him right there. So, one, two, three. Okay. No, you're not gonna attack with your javelin, you're gonna use your iron lance and you're gonna stay there. You are going to stay right here. You're gonna go down here. Yeah, excuse me if commentary is a little bare bones right now. It's just mostly because of the fact that I've already played this mission and I actually already have an idea of what to do. We're gonna let you buy two of these. And yeah, that should be good. You are gonna go down here and you're gonna purchase two fluxes, just like we did. Alright, cool. And yeah, you're gonna go here. Great. Now let's hurry up and make it so that the enemies can actually do their attacky attacks. Oswin is very, very defensive, and luckily he can't actually kill them, because this makes it very easy for me to actually use Raven to pick up the kill. Now, let's see, what do we gotta do? We're gonna make it so that Raven can get DXPs, because unfortunately, as of this point, he can't actually get the double attack off because he's a little too slow. Luckily, Canis should be able to murk this guy with no problem at all. But that shouldn't be an issue. Hey, you got a level. Huh. Okay. But anyway, let's see if we can get this done as quickly as possible. I kind of expected him to get attacked. Alright, good. Come on. Oh shit, sorry, I hit my mic. Okay. Well, at least, well, Canis will definitely be able to get the kill, so that's not a problem. We can make him back off, and then we can have Lucius go in and clean up, because Priscilla needs to heal him up. But Priscilla also needs to heal up Raven as well, so there's that. Okay, so anything, Canis, go back here, get the attack off on this guy. Good stuff. Now he's out of the way, and we can actually put Lucius down here, and he can get either or, doesn't matter who. Bam. Yeah, against shamans, Lucius is a Guster song in the sense that he is a one-man wrecking machine. Anyway, so let's see. Come on. It's okay. It's an okay level up. It's aight. So, yeah, definitely Raven, you are going to get healed, and yeah, we had Urk go ahead and, Urk, you're gonna go ahead and get a kill here. Technically, we could have had Florina do that. Kind of an oversight on my part, but whatevs, it's fine. So now, this actually allows, Raven to move up here? Actually, no, Priscilla, go over here, heal him up. Mend, heal you up. Cool. Now we can use Rebecca, I believe, to get the attack up on this guy. Huh. Not enough. Not enough. Maybe a javelin from her? No. This is interesting. Very interesting. Okay, he can get two attacks off. So maybe we can actually use Florina to get some damage on him. That shouldn't be that much of an issue. Yeah, great. Good stuff, good stuff. Now, considering that, Raven, move over here and get the attacky-tacks on this guy. If anything, we can actually use a steel sword, but it's not, not that big of an issue. So now, we could hope for a crit. I sincerely doubt it's gonna happen, but we could hope for a crit. Okay, because we need to make it so that we open up the path for him. And we have options. It's just none of them are particularly amazing. If anything, go ahead, guy. Kill him. Kill him for me. You'd be doing me a massive favor. And Osmond, I need you to take out the shaman. Ah, you shit stain. Alright. Okay. Yeah, I don't know. This is a product of me being really, really, like, fast and loose with my expectations, because I don't necessarily need to be moving this aggressively towards the enemy, but whatevs. So if anything, Elowit, you're gonna stay here. You're gonna protect. But wait. Alright, good. Raven's actually getting the double attack off, which is fantastic for me. Okay. Well, Guy should be totally fine. If anything, all we need to do is make sure that he doesn't get hit by that shaman. Oh, hey. Dodge. Yay. Yeah, oh, Rebecca will be totally fine. She'll be able to wipe this dude out. No problem. There we go. It's probably a slight oversight on my part for putting her that far forward, just because of the fact that we could have had Lucius or Canis get the kill, because we really need them to get the XP. Good, he at least dodged that, so that's fantastic. Alrighty. Now, Raven, go and attack this homie. Good. It's an okay level up. That is okay. And you got a longsword. Longswords are actually interesting. We'll put back the long blade. So now, Guy, you'll be moved back. And Rebecca, you'll also be moved back. We don't need you. You don't need this, like, many people far forward. If anything. Ooh. We need to make it so that someone can get a kill. How about we do it this way? So someone needs to kill this guy so they actually can get the red gem, because we're gonna put Florina down here. And she's gonna get. Oh shit. Alright, okay, never mind. That's the Lance Reaver. Actually, maybe she can actually do it with her Steel Lance? Yeah, she has a really low chance of hitting, so it's not necessarily the best idea. I mean, we can have Canis get the kill. But the thing is, I really want to take out the archer, and we can do that pretty damn easily. It's just I need to make sure that this guy has to die. So we have a couple options. Who would most benefit from this level? So Priscilla, move over here. And Mancanis. Your brother, Raven, should be totally fine. And, okay, this is good. So we're gonna use Canis to take out the... And we're gonna use him to take out the archer. Yeah, we're gonna use him to take out the archer. Because we can use Urk to take out the Lance Reaver, and then we can place Osvin 4 to take out the Shaman. And that was exactly enough to get a level. Great. It could have been a better level up, but whatever. Great, Steel Gem. Not Steel Gem, Ruby. Red Gem? I'm sure it's a Ruby. Anyway, you gonna get killed. Good stuff. Now, Oswin, take out this guy. Alright, there we go. And from here, what do we need to do? He has the Armor Slayer, so... If anything, this will be fine. We don't need to have her placed back there, because he should be okay to handle himself. Lucius, you will wait here. You should be able to kill these guys, no problem. And Matthew, wait here. Elwood, you don't need to really do anything. I mean, if anything, you can just merch and give that and equip your iron sword. There we go. Now we wait. Alright, Raven should be totally fine. Hey, you got the crit off. Yeah, the guy shouldn't be able to do enough damage to kill him straight out. Yeah, he'll be fine. He's very close to dying, however. But he'll be fine. Oswin is not gonna get any damage from this guy. Full beans. And Lucius should be able to kill them with no problem. And there it is. Yay! Okay, so now... Wait, almost done. Hey, we got a guiding ring. There we go. Alright, now it's our turn. Just in case, we'll have Priscilla heal him up with her mend staff. Because it would be terrible if Raven died. Good heals, good heals. And kill this guy. I guess it's okay if Florina gets the kill. Because she does need some XP as well, because she's only level 9. So, Oswin, you don't need to be here. You're gonna move down. Go down, and then Florina, go ahead and get some attacks off. Anything, you can use your Iron Lance. Yeah, that's fine. Oh, yo, the crit. Okay. Unnecessary, but alright. And from here. Yeah, she has a lot of healing to do, which is fine. Canis, you're gonna go. How far? So she can have. She has a movement of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We will place him here because I want him to get healed before we actually move him around. Now, let's see. Yeah, Urk can move down here. Yeah, this will be good. And if anything, we can preemptively place these two down here. Actually, Guy also needs to be healed. Fuck. Yeah, we'll wait. We'll wait. We don't need to be this in a rush. Alright, good. Florinia should definitely be able to get to level 10 with no problem. Yeah, he's not gonna be able to reach down there, so that's fine. But we do need him to get some levels. We might be able to get it in the next chapter. Granted, if we actually make it that far. Without losing anybody too important, fuck. I actually legitimately don't know what to do with that other recording, because it's there, I have it. It's not deleted. Not that I would actually end up deleting it. So the problem is that a lot of the stuff that I could go over now, like I already explained in that video, and I think I actually did rather a good job explaining the kind of stuff that I wanted to explain. So it seems really... what's the word? I already got done saying what I want to say in the other video, so if I were to do it here, you guys would be missing out on the stuff that I would otherwise would have wanted you guys to hear. I don't exactly know what to do with it. I mean, I could upload it, but it would have to be maybe like a part one, part two. I mean, it could be cool to show you guys. I mean, all the failures that I have, and I'm not necessarily against that idea. I think it'd be cool. Anything? Yeah, I think that's what I'll do. I will upload it, I'll render it out, and then I'll make it so that it's a part one. And I'll also put this one as like a part two or something like that. All right, let's end. Nice crit. Okay, Alan, yeah, another thing that I actually did not mention in the last episode is that chapter 15, it's uploaded and it got all bunged up, which is unfortunate because it's the audio is off by at least 1 second, and that's really shitty. I watched it and it looks really bad, like legitimately very bad. So, I don't know, it was just an error in the rendering that I was doing, so that's my fault. Alrighty, you're gonna stay here. You are going to fly over here. You really worry about this music. So, Guy, I legitimately need you to be in tip-top shape. So, we're still gonna do the same strategy that we did in the last one, because it makes the most sense for us to use him to get the kill. Cause one, he needs the XP, and also he's probably the only one who can really take out the boss this quickly. So we're gonna place these guys here preemptively. Let's see. You can stay down here, clean up. Everything looks more or less fine, so let's end. Okay. Now, we need to make it so that Guy should be in position. You're gonna place Matthew down here. Place these people right here. Yeah, everything looks fine. Oh, this is scary. This is legitimately terrifying. Priscilla, you will heal somebody, doesn't matter who. Might as well heal Florina, because she's going to be going against the boss relatively soon. Okay. Place you here. Raven, you're going to go here. Oswin, here. Anything? Let's move Elowood down. He could be of use. And you will stay here. Yeah, this looks fine. Yeah, more reinforcements! Yay! They should be attacking him. As Oh no, hey! What the fuck? No, thank you, dog. You don't crit me. That nonsense. Get that shit out of here. Okay. Well, if anything, Raven, clean him up. Fuck this guy for critting you. Thank you. Level 8. Good, good, good. She'll be able to kill him. And now we should be able to... We can use Florina to do this. Anyway, Ollie will be right back. Yeah, I'll be right back. Go eat dinner, and also, made some tea. Some, celestial seasonings, cinnamon apple... stuff. Anyway, let's get back into it. So... I kind of forgot what we're actually doing. Oh, hey, yeah, that's what's going on. We need to make it so that we can take out the rest of these, enemies. And if anything, we also want to make it so that he can get healed. Well, if we take out the enemies, then he should be totally fine. So if anything, let's use Rebecca to take him out while we... Yeah, we have to use Rebecca. So one of the other options that I was considering is that, hey, we could actually use the other units to actually finish them off, or we can at least just funnel everyone to attack Raven. The problem is, I don't necessarily trust his dodging abilities, so unfortunately that's not going to necessarily be the case. Anything? So... Yeah, I'm going to use Urk to take out... the shaman, and then I'm also going to have Priscilla heal up either Raven or him. It doesn't matter who gets healed up at this particular point. So, well, it'll have to be Raven just because of the fact that he is the only one that actually can be reached. So, Raven, get healed, son, and drink my tea. Huh, it's more fragrant than anything. It feels like I'm just drinking hot water. Alright, so, first things first. Go over here, steal the speed wing. And you will get rescued by Florina. And we'll fly you up here, and we will wait. Guy can't reach, so we'll just wait here. And everyone else should be more or less in order. Yeah, I'll actually leave Elowood up here, and Oswin up here. And the rest of the unit should be fine to wait. I guess I anticipated as much for him to get the attack off, but Urk should be fast enough to... so that the Myrmidon won't actually get the second attack off. You really, really need some magic and skill. Because it's a really shitty level up. Alright, it's almost the moment of truth. I'm gonna place you here. And the thing is that we need to do this all over again. Shit, this is scary. So, yep, you're gonna get the kill on this guy. And then you are gonna get healed, son. Well, Urk is gonna get healed, son. any units over here. There are some units. So if anything, we will place Osmond here. And someone should end up getting attacked. Yeah, Urk will definitely need to get healed. And Raven should attract the attention of those two mercenaries at the bottom, and I'm imagining that Florina will be the one getting attacked by that Pegasus Knight, so we don't need to worry too much about that. Alright, we're almost done. We are almost done. So let's wait. Alright, he should get the kill on this guy. Hey, you got the crit. And wham! Oh, this is very scary. Alright, yep. I anticipate as much. Lucius should be able to get the kill on this Pegasus Knight, so that's not an issue. I would really love for if Priscilla could actually like heal Lucius up, but I mean, it's not strictly necessary. Oswin, you know what? You are a baller right now, so I need you to go ahead and get the kill on these guys. No one else is going to be able to reach them, since it's just free XP for you, so not a problem. And besides, a lot of the units are actually catching up to you in terms of, level, so that's not an issue. So you're going to get attacked, and you'll definitely be able to get the kill. So the thing is that Priscilla might not be able to actually get away from the Pegasus Knight that's on the right of us. If worst comes to worst, she shouldn't... Like, I'm pretty sure she won't be able to die. It'd be really, really illogical. Holy shit, that's an amazing level. Yeah, this person's only using a slim lance. But I will move her away from these guys, because... I'm gonna move Rebecca up here. But I'm also going to move Priscilla up there as well. It should be out of range, and also she gets some more XP for healing somebody. Okay, cool. Now, the moment of truth! This is fucking scary, but let's do it. You're going to use your Slim Lance to take this guy on, and then Guy is going to take you out. All right. Round two, let's go. Oh, okay, my heart skipped a beat right there, holy shit. And I hit the mic again, fuck. Alright, do it. Oh, thank you, he didn't get crit. Didn't get critted into oblivion. Why did you do that in the first place? Ah, Guy! You're killing me! Alright. You possess this much power. Must warrant. Blah. Oh. Woo! Asshole! Alright, at least you got the kill. Fuck. And you got the world's worst level up. Ahoy, I'm back. Now who wants to die first? Alright. What, you've already routed them? Nicely done, whelp. Those sea dogs were no match for us. Ah, Ninian, you can't come out yet. There's blood everywhere. Blood? Look out. Ah, I'm sorry. Are you okay, Ninian? Ninian? Is that me? Is that my name? Ninian, what's happened to you? My head is so foggy. Am I at sea? Yes, we found you adrift in a small boat. Those scum were after the girl, it seems. Will you take her with you? The men are afraid she might be cursed, you know. Cursed? Are you suggesting we leave Ninian behind? We can't take her with us, can we? We're heading for the Dread Isle. It's dread for a reason, you know. Regardless, she goes with us. Lindis? When I saw her, I remembered something. The last time I saw Ninian, she and her brother were being hunted by some dark-robed men. Dark-robed? Are you sure? Yes, I think it must be the Black Fang. It didn't occur to me before, but now I'm certain. How can you be sure? I can't explain. There's something in the air that hints at their involvement. If it's true, then she's likely to be attacked again. Almost certainly, we can't leave her behind. I'll watch over her, please. I understand. We should be by her side to protect her. Thank you. We're all going to that island. Will you come with us? Yes. Please, take me with you. We've arrived. Thank you very much. We'll wait 2 weeks. Finish up by then. That's more than enough time. And I've got a half-wit soldier who wants to go sightseeing. Come here, Dart! I'm here, Captain. Ready to serve. We're pleased to have you. His only redeeming feature is his sturdiness. Maybe he'll come in handy. Come on, Captain. I'm better than that. You've done so much. I can't thank you enough. Come back alive. That's all the thanks I need. Alright, farewell. We'll be back before you know it. Thari are good people, even among pirates. I don't think the old man and his group are your average pirates. Somewhere within that forest is the Dragon's Gates. Elwood, no matter what it takes, we're coming back with your father. We'll surely find him. We'll all do our best to make it so. You're right. Let's make preparations to enter the forest. Oh! Dragon's Gate. Ginian, what is it? It's nothing. Holy shit! Well, that took like 2 attempts to actually do, but we fucking did it! Alright, I might have ended the level preemptively just because I killed the boss, but whatever. At least we didn't fucking lose a unit, so yeah, I think this is where I'm gonna end the episode. So thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, please hit the like button, it helps out a great deal, and of course subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in Chapter 18, the Dread Isle.